whatever we have discussed in this particular charge of GST, the same will be discussed by us. So, first of all, we have discussed about the enactments that there is Central Goods and Services Tax Act. One is Integrated Goods and Services Tax Act. These two acts are in your courts. And there are, say, 29 states and two union territories without these, say, with the legislature, that's Delhi and Puducherry. For them, 29 states and two union territories with legislature, SGST Act is there. There are 31 different SGST enactments, so for Delhi as well as for Puducherry, SGST Act is there. And union territory without the legislature, there's a single enactment, UTGST Act. So say we are having CGST Act 2017, we are having SGST Acts 2017 for those 29 states plus two union territories, Delhi and Puducherry. And we have one UTGST Act and we have IGST Act, Integrated Goods and Services Tax Act 2017, which is dealing with the provisions relating to supply of interstate supply of goods or services. So, what is the extent and commencement of CGST Act, SGST Act, UTGST Act and IGST Act basically? So, here CGST Act extends to whole of India, including all the states, all the union territories, with the legislature or without, say, their own legislature. So, states of India, CGST Act is applicable. UTGST Act is there with the legislature, or say union territories with the legislature is there or without legislature is there, CGST Act extends to them. Now, SGST Act, it applies to all the states which have been given the status of states, as well as union territories with the legislature, and here Delhi and Puducherry is covered. Then in a union territories without legislature, a single enactment is there for Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Dadar and Nagar Haveli, Daman and Diu and Chandigarh. Therefore, those union territories, there is one single enactment, UTGST Act. So, for intrastate supply of goods or services, what is taxes are levied for intrastate supplies? What taxes are levied? CGST plus SGST or UTGST. For interstate supplies, integrated tax is levied. It is known as central tax, it is known as state tax, it is known as union territory tax, basically. Then, charging section under CGST is which section? Section 9. Under IGST Act, it is what? Section 5. So, central tax is levied on intrastate supply of goods or services or both. Integrated tax is levied on interstate supply of goods or services or both. So, this has been there, this summary is there in our compiler also. The beginning of the compiler is summary only. But summary will be useful only when we study entire subject, the entire chapter. Certain students have a bona fide belief that only by summary they will pass the exam. So, they will get summarized marks only there. Also, that is to be kept in mind. So, here, under CGST Act, the same intrastate supply of goods or services or both is leviable, and under IGST Act, levy is on what? Interstate supply of goods or services or both. And GST will be collected by a taxable person and paid by a taxable person. Who is a taxable person? Who is registered or is liable to be registered? Then, which supply is outside the purview of GST? as we already discussed, alcoholic liquor for human consumption, the same is outside the purview of GST. Then, what is the value on which GST is to be levied, whether it is an interstate supply or whether it is an intrastate supply? Even if it is an interstate supply or intrastate supply, the value will be the transaction value. And the transaction value will be determined as per the provisions of Section 15 of the Act, and basically it is the invoice price. Whatever price we are charging from our client, that is the transaction value in respect of the goods or say services. Then GST will be levied at the rates which have been notified by the government on the recommendation of council. And say we have on certain commodities, we have nil rate. On certain commodities is 5%. 5% means 2.5% CGST and 2.5% what? SGST. In certain commodities we have say 12%, 18% and the maximum rate is 28%. Though the maximum rate which can be notified by the government on recommendation of council is 20% CGST and 40% say IGST. But here 28% is notified. Then, as per the provisions of Section 9(2) or 5(2), on these petroleum products, GST will be levied on such date as the government, from such date as the government notifies on the recommendation of the council. That is petroleum crude, high-speed diesel oil, motor spirit commonly known as petrol, natural gas and aviation turbine fuel. Then we have, this was under 9(2), 5(2). Then, as per the provisions of Section 9(3) and 9(4), 5(3) and 5(4), supply of goods and service, goods and or services which are notified by the government, and here this is basically 9(4), supplied, or say this is 9(4). Supply on specified category of goods or services or both from unregistered supplier to specified class of what? Registered person. This is 9(4). This is what? 9(3). Here, reverse charge mechanism will be applicable where the recipient of the goods or services will be liable to pay GST. Then we discussed what? 9(5), 5(5). What we discussed? 9(5), 5(5). The government may notify specified category of services, the tax on which shall be paid by the electronic commerce operator if such services are supplied through it. And we have seen the services of transportation of passengers by radio taxi, motor cab, maxi cab, motorcycle. It's transportation of passengers, hotel accommodation, and housekeeping services which have been notified. In case these services are supplied through a platform which is owned by e-commerce operator, so in that particular case we are using other person's platform to supply these services, then the e-commerce operator, say Ola, Uber, Amazon, Flipkart, these are what? The e-commerce operators. So from their platform, if we are supplying the notified services, e-commerce operator, electronic commerce operator will be liable to pay GST on the same. And in case even electronic commerce operator is located in the taxable territory, then that is very good. That person will be liable to pay the tax. If e-commerce operator does not have a physical presence in the taxable territory, then person who is representing such electronic commerce operator is liable to pay the tax. And in case if e-commerce operator has neither physical presence nor any representative in the taxable territory, then the person liable for paying tax is the person appointed by the ECO for the purpose of paying the tax. So that person will be appointed. Then in case of goods which are imported into India, it is not an intrastate supply, when it is not an intrastate supply, CGST and SGST cannot be levied. Import of goods, as per the provisions of Section 7 of the IGST Act, import of goods is deemed to be interstate supply. The same is deemed to be interstate supply. So, on import of goods, integrated tax shall be levied and collected as duties of customs. So, on import of goods, integrated tax will be levied and collected as what? Duties of customs. Then we have discussed certain services which have been notified under reverse charge mechanism. So, what services have been notified under reverse charge mechanism? In this case, we have seen that there is a services of transportation of goods by road. If GTA is providing services, if GTA is providing services to these persons, who are the persons? That is a factory registered under the Factories Act, society registered under the Societies Act, cooperative societies, persons who are registered under GST law, body corporates, partnership firms, including, say, association of persons, LLPs covered under the ambit of partnership firm, casual taxable persons. These are located where? In the taxable territory. These are located where? In the taxable territory. And rate of GST is 5%. And rate of GST is 5%. In 5%, the goods and transport agency, goods transport agency won't be entitled to take the credit. So rate of GST is where 5%, then reverse charge mechanism is, say, applicable. And these persons are liable to pay GST on the same. But we have also seen that in case the government departments are there, local authorities there, and these governmental agencies are there, who are required to get registered only for the purpose of tax deduction at source, and they are not supplying what? Taxable goods and services on their own account. Say if a government department is availing services of GTA and is registered, as per the above provision, any registered person avails the services of GTA, RCM applies. But government department registered only for the purpose of what? Tax deduction at source. If the contract value exceeds 2,50,000, then the government department is required to deduct tax at source while making payment to the suppliers of the, say, goods or suppliers of services, as the case may be. In that case, if a government department has got themselves registered only for the purpose of tax deduction at source, then there is no reverse charge mechanism applicable in such case. Similarly, if services are provided to an unregistered person also, then basically reverse charge mechanism will not be there. Both these services have been made exempt from GST itself. If a GTA services are availed by whom? An unregistered person. There is the entry 21A of the notification number 12/2017 city rate, which exempts the goods, which exempts the services. Similarly, what? If government department avails the services of GTA, the same is also, say, exempt in case the government department is registered only for the purpose of what? Tax deduction. So there is no question of reverse charge in such a case. Similarly, in case of any legal services, being, say, individual advocate, including senior advocate or firm of advocates, they are what? Providing services to a business entity located in taxable territory. Reverse charge mechanism is there. Then arbitral tribunal is providing services to a business entity located in taxable territory. Then in that case also, reverse charge mechanism is there. That is, the business entity located in the taxable territory will be liable to pay GST on the same. Then there is what? Supply of services, sponsorship services. Hindustan Unilever is sponsoring, say, Miss India contest. So Hindustan Unilever is basically the recipient of service. Who is what? Service suppliers, maybe the event person, those who are managing the event. They will be exhibiting the name of Hindustan Unilever everywhere. So it's a body corporate or the firm which is located in the taxable territory, being Unilever, will be liable to pay what? GST on the same. So sponsorship services by way of sponsorship services. Then in case if government, central government, state government, union territory or local authority provides services to business entities located where? In the taxable territory, reverse charge mechanism is applicable. The business entity located in the taxable territory will be liable to pay GST on the same. And in case if it is what, say, renting of immovable property is there, renting of immovable property which has been supplied by the government to non-registered person, because entry 5A is also there na? So here, renting of immovable properties to a non-registered person, same will be covered under forward charge. Then services of, say, department of post, say, by way of speed post, express parcel post, agency services, services in relation to any aircraft or vessel inside the or outside the precincts of port or airport, or say transportation of goods or passengers. So Indian Railways is supplying services of transportation of say passengers, and we say that all the passengers get themselves registered under GST and pay GST under reverse charge. That is not possible. Therefore, these services, which are exception, they are covered under what? Forward charge mechanism, where the government department or say the union territory or the local authority will be liable to pay GST. However, if it is a renting of immovable property by the central government, state government, union territory or local authority to registered person, the services by way of renting of immovable property, central government, state government, union territory, they are owning the premises and given the said premises to rent on rent to a registered person. In such a case, reverse charge mechanism is there. The registered person will be what? Liable to pay GST. Then in case there are directors of the company or say body corporates. So if one is that those directors who are employee, GST liability doesn't arise. But in case Mr. Chaman is appointed as an independent director of Aman Private Limited, in that case, what will happen? That Chaman is an independent director. He will be not liable to pay GST. It is the company who is availing the services of Chamanji will be what? Liable to pay GST. Similarly, there is an insurance agent. Insurance agents are there. They are engaged in marketing of insurance company policies. So here, the insurance company will be liable to pay GST. There are recovery agents which have been appointed by a banking company or a financial institution or NBFC located in the taxable territory. So in that particular case, recovery agent services, the banking company, financial institution, or say NBFC located in what? The taxable territory. Then there are say agents which are providing services to the banking correspondents. So in that case, those agents which are supplying services to the banking correspondents, the banking correspondents will be liable to pay GST. In respect of author, providing services of what? Transfer of copyrights of literary work to publisher, RCM is applicable. But if author can opt for payment of tax under forward charge mechanism, and option will be valid for what? For a financial year. In that case, the publisher won't be liable to pay tax under the reverse charge mechanism. Besides, in case of music composers, photographers, artists or the like, in that case, RCM is applicable and the music company, producer and the like will be liable to pay GST on the same. There are members of overseeing committee which are supplying services to RBI. In that case, RBI is liable to pay the GST. Then individual direct selling agents are there, other than body corporates, partnership firms or LLP. So in that particular case, the services are supplied to a banking company or say the non-banking financial institution which are located where? In the taxable territory. In that particular circumstance, the banking company will be what? Liable to pay GST on the same. There are, we have already discussed that there are agents who are supplying services to business correspondents. Agents are supplying services to business correspondents. In that case, business correspondent is liable to pay GST. There are business facilitators also which are providing services to whom? Banking company. In that case, the banking company located in the taxable territory will be liable to pay GST under reverse charge. Now, security services are there. Security services are provided by a person other than body corporates. So here security services are required in various companies, etc. And we see everywhere also security services have been there. So in case if security services are supplied, that is supply of security personnel is there, security services are provided to a registered person, then in that particular circumstance, security services are provided to a registered person, reverse charge mechanism is applicable. The service supplier must not be a body corporate. If XYZ Detective and Security Limited is supplying security personnel, in that case, what will happen? Forward charge mechanism will be there. But if it is not a company, it's XYZ and firm, which is what? providing security services to any person, registered person, reverse charge mechanism is applicable. But here also, if government departments are registered, only for the purpose of tax deduction at source, and they are not required to get themselves registered in normal manner because they are not supplying any taxable goods or services. In that particular circumstance, what? RCM will not be applicable. Similarly, if a registered composition supplier, avails services or security services, in that case also, reverse charge mechanism is not applicable. Then we have seen that these two entries have further been added by the, with effect from 1st of October 2019, that if there is services of renting of motor vehicle is provided to a body corporate. Service supplier must not be a body corporate. Renting of motor vehicle service is supplied to a body corporate. In that case, reverse charge mechanism is applicable. So here, basically, rate of GST is what? 5%. In case of this particular, when rate they are paying GST at rate of 5%, then reverse charge mechanism is applicable. And they won't be entitled to take any credit except what? Credit of input services of the same line of business. So any person other than a body corporate paying central tax at rate of 5%, whether central tax at rate of 2.5% or integrated tax at rate of 5%, with input tax credit only in respect of input service in the same line of business. And services are supplied to whom? A body corporate. So here, body corporate will be liable to pay GST under what? Reverse charge mechanism. And there is a security lending scheme. I am the lender. Lending is through approved intermediary to a borrower. And the lender is charging kya? Lending fees for the same. And the borrower is required to return the same quantity and same nature of security back to the lender. In that, borrower is required to return the same to the lender. So services are supplied by the lender, but here the borrower is liable to pay GST under what? Reverse charge mechanism. So six services of, say, lending of securities under security lending scheme, lender is supplying security to the borrower through approved intermediary, but lender and borrower, that is lender does not know who is a borrower because the transaction is routed through what? Approved intermediaries. Intermediaries will be charging their commission. So their separate service is what? Separate service. And this service is a separate service. Lender will be charging fees and borrower will be getting the security for the time frame. He may do whatever he like with the security, but will be required to return the security back after the agreement. So whatever lending fees is there, in that particular circumstance, borrower will be liable to pay GST under reverse charge. This is basically not transaction in security, because they say that here there is no supply of security as such. Securities are only given to the borrower. That is, lending transaction is there. That same is not covered in the ambit of, say, sale of such securities. Therefore, it will be covered under the purview of GST. And on securities lending, under securities lending, the lender will not be liable to pay GST from with effect from 1st of October 2019. It is the borrower who will be liable to pay GST in the same. So these two services have been introduced. So this was all about which we have discussed under this. Besides this, we have also discussed relating to what certain classification of goods and services, that classification of goods, this based on harmonized commodity description and coding system, and services are classified as per the services accounting code. So this was the about our charge, that is section 9 and section 5. You must remember all the services which are covered under reverse charge mechanism, because when they give practical questions, so they say that XYZ Limited has availed legal consultancy services. So as soon as you, that must click in your mind that here XYZ Limited will be liable to pay tax under RCM on this, and reverse charge mechanism tax is to be paid only through electronic cash ledger. First of all, the tax will be deposited to the treasury of the government through electronic cash ledger, and then only credit will be what? Allowed of the same in electronic credit ledger in case the said service what? Qualifies to be an input service. So you cannot utilize what? Electronic credit ledger balance to pay tax under what? Reverse charge. So in case your presentation must be in such a manner that this much tax can be, say this is your output tax liability, the same can be used, it can be paid through electronic credit ledger. Say our output tax liability is 5 lakh rupees and we are having a credit balance to the extent of say 480,000 rupees. So only 20,000 rupees is required to be deposited in say cash. And this reverse charge that is to be shown separately, because you cannot add the same in the output tax liability. This is to be paid only through what? Electronic cash ledger. So this was all about which we have discussed here. And our next chapter will be composition levy, which will be starting from tomorrow.